Welcome back. So we will continue with column buckling. As mentioned in previous lecture, the critical load is depend on the effective length, and the effective length is depend on the joint at both end of the column. Basically, for this chapter, we just need to focus on four conditions, which are fixed free, pin pin, pin fix, and fix fix. Let us go through one example and see how to identify the effective length and apply the critical load formula to solve the problem. Okay, so for these questions, so we have a fixed end at B, and we have a round fixed plate restraint at the end A. Basically, for the end A, we have two type of conditions. It depends how does the column bend. So we will talk further later on, and then we look at the questions. Basically, the question asks to determine the ratio of AB, and based on the most efficient design against buckling. Okay, so to answer these questions, right, we need to look at how does the beam or the column bend, right? The first, we have two plan need to consider. One is the plan XY, and the other one is the plan XZ. Okay, so we will talk about it later. Next, furthermore, for this question, we need to design the most efficient cross section for the column, which means for this question B, we need to identify the value for A and B. So for buckling in XY plane, is considered pin fix. Okay, so let's look at point A or the end A. The end A is considered pin N. So why is pin N? Because there is no movement on Y directions and free to rotate. And at the end B is considered fixed N. So for this buckling in XY plane, the neutral axis is lie on the Z axis. So which means the IZ is equals to 1 over 12 BA cube. IZ is the moment inertia about Z axis. So this, because it's a pin fix, so the L effective is 0.7 L. The area, cross-section area, is A times B, and the moment of inertia is equals to A area multiplied with R squared. R is the radius of gyrations. So rearrange the equations and substitute the moment of inertia about Z-axis into the equation and the area. So we will get the radius of gyration equals to A divided by square root of 12. So the slenderness ratio will be L effective divided by the radius of gyration, so which equals to 0.7 square root of 12 multiplied with L divided by A. Now we look at the buckling in exact plane. So the buckling in exact plane is considered fixed free. So the NA is considered a free end because free movement on Z directions and free to rotate. So therefore the A is considered free end. And same for the NB is considered fixed end. Right, so for the buckling on exact plane, the neutral axis is lie on the y-axis. So therefore, the moment of inertia about y-axis is equals to 1 over 12 multiplied with a times b cubed. So for the fixed free, the L effective is equals to 2L. Same thing, the rest. Okay, so rearrange the equations and then substitute the moment of inertia about y-axis and the area. So we will get the radius of gyrations is equals to b divided by square root of 12. So the cylinder's ratio is equals to L effective divided by radius of gyrations. So equals to 12 multiplied with a square root of 12 multiplied with L divided by b. For the most effective design, the slenderness ratio for both plane must be the same. So therefore, L effective divided by R Z equals to L effective divided by R Y. So by substitute the parameter, so we will get the ratio A divided by B equals to 0.35. So this is the answer for part A. Part B is to determine the value for A and B. So with given data, the safety factor equals 2.5 and then the L equals to 20 inch. So for the safety factor, we know that the safety factor is equal to critical load divided by applied load. So the critical load can be determined from the equations. And we know that since that from part A, A divided by B equals to 0.35 and the area equals AB, so equals to 0.35 B squared. For the critical stress is equals to critical load divided by the area. So substitute the A into the equations. So the critical stress will become 12500 divided by 0.35 B squared. And then we just take one of the slenderness ratio, can be either in plan XY or plan XZ. Both will give the same answer. So so we use the slenderness ratio and then substitute the L value, so you will get 138.6 divided by B. Okay, so from the formula for the critical stress and substitute to the two parameter into the equation, so and perform the calculations, so we will get the B equals 1.62 inch, and then substitute the B into either the ratio A divided by B equals to 0.35 or A equals to 0.35 B. Okay, so from there we are able to determine the A value, which is 0.567 inch. Let's move on to another example, question 4.4. For this question, it's quite straightforward. So basically, all parameter can be obtained from the diagram. And the question asks to determine the critical load for the square strut. Okay, so for this, you just need to apply the critical load formula to calculate the critical load for the square strut. Okay, so B is to determine the radius of the round strut where both struts have a same critical load. Okay, so for this, you just need to apply the critical load for the round is equal to the critical load for the square. And lastly, so for part C, we need to determine the cross-sectional area for the square strut as a percent of the cross-section area of the round strut. Okay, so just determine the ratio a square divided by a round multiplied with 100%. Okay, so a solution. So for the square strut, okay, so we are able to calculate the area and then calculate the I moment of inertia for the square strut. After that, insert both parameter into the critical load equations. So from there, we are able to determine the critical load is equals to 46.3 kilonewton. Okay, so for part B, so since that both struts have the same critical load, so therefore, so apply the critical load formula for both and then cancel off because there's the same value. Because for the LE, LE depend the joint at both ends. So for both cases, they are having a same joint, which is pin-pin at both ends. So therefore, can be canceled off for the L effective. Okay, so therefore, after we cancel off, so the moment of inertia for the round strut is equals to moment of inertia for the square strut. Okay, so just apply the moment of inertia formula for both, and we are able to determine the radius for the round strut, which is equals to 14.27 millimeter. Okay, so for part C, the percentage. Okay, so we have the area for the round strut and we have the area for the square strut. So just apply the ratio formula. So you will get 97.7%.